Hey skincare nerds, welcome back. So ever since I started my channel, one of the most requested topics has been about how to get rid of tiny bumps. A lot of you might be thinking that your tiny bumps are fungal acne, but before you put that anti-dandruff shampoo on your face, keep watching this video because I'm gonna talk about something else that may be causing your tiny bumps called closed comedones or CCs. We're gonna talk about what closed comedones are, the difference between fungal acne and CCs, what to avoid, and the products and ingredients that I recommend that are gonna help you get rid of them. Okay, so before we get started, I just have to say that this is a pretty complicated topic to cover, and fungal acne does get misdiagnosed even by professional dermatologists. So if you do have access to a dermatologist, please consider seeing one so they can give you an actual diagnosis and help you with treatment. But since dermatologists are really inaccessible to most of us, I'm gonna do my absolute best to try and break down all the research for you and be as helpful as I can on your journey to get healthier, better looking skin. I've been obsessed with the science of skincare for as long as I can remember, and I do a lot of research on all my videos. So as always, I will be including my sources down in the description box below so you can read. Okay, so let's talk about those tiny bumps. Maybe you just added a new product to your routine, like an exfoliating toner or a new moisturizer, and seemingly overnight, you have these little bumps popping up on your skin that kind of look like they're under your skin surface. Or maybe you've been dealing with them for a while and they just don't seem to be going away. Maybe you've even seen someone on TikTok talking about fungal acne and you're thinking, that's what I have, right? But is it really fungal acne? Or is it closed comedones? Or is it both? It's really important that you try and figure this out because the products and the ingredients that you use to deal with fungal acne and closed comedones are really different. In fact, if you're putting a shampoo on your face because you think you have fungal acne, but you actually have closed comedones, then that might aggravate your skin and actually make you break out even more. Okay, so first, how can you tell if it's fungal acne? So the easiest way to tell if it's fungal acne or not is, does it feel itchy? And the second is to focus on what they look like. Are the bumps kind of all clustered together and look all kind of like a similar size? The third is, what color are they? Are they pinkish if you have slightly lighter skin, or are they darker if you have darker skin? And number four, is it on your forehead and kind of extending up into your hairline? If you answered yes to all four of those questions, so if it is kind of itchy and you have a cluster of them that all look kind of the same size, plus the bumps are pinkish or darker in color if you have darker skin, and they're on your forehead extending up into your hairline, then it could be fungal acne. Treating fungal acne is another topic I get a lot of requests about, so I definitely will be doing a video about that very, very soon. And I'll get into more of the nitty-gritty around the lifestyle factors, like if you're an athlete or if you live in a humid climate, but I'm not gonna focus on that in this week's video. And now, what about closed comedones? If those bumps are not itchy, they're skin colored and maybe a little bit white, they're all different sizes and kind of spaced out. They show up on your forehead, cheeks, and chin, and they also show up with a few pimples and even blackheads as well, then you've probably got closed comedones. And that's what we are gonna focus on this week. So what are closed comedones or CCs? We're gonna get a little bit technical here, but if you're still watching, you knew this was coming. So think of your pore lining as kind of like a flower vase. Sometimes the opening gets blocked because of a buildup of cells and an increase in sebum or oil. So when that blockage becomes a clog because of the dead skin cell buildup, the oil, and even bacteria that gets stuck inside, it can become a tiny bump. And that tiny bump can look white or it can look skin colored as well. So there you have it, that's a closed comedone. CCs are basically just the same thing as a whitehead. I really don't like calling it a whitehead because technically it can be skin color too, and I think that can cause a lot of confusion. So what happens next? Well, it might burst open. And when it does, those sticky skin cells have pigment in them that when they're exposed to air, look black. And you basically get a blackhead. It's a common misconception that black color comes from dirt, and that's just not true. Dirt and makeup can totally make it worse, but that's not what's causing it to look black. Wait, there's more in the life cycle of a closed comedone. If the excess oil, bacteria, and dead skin cells end up pushing deeper into the skin, it can actually cause inflammation, and the skin-colored bumps end up turning into small red bumps. Closed comedones are basically just an early form of a pimple. So if you've got both CCs and pimples, that is totally normal. If you're lucky and you just have closed comedones, those tiny bumps, then you still want to get rid of them because you don't want them to turn into inflamed pimples down the road. So now that you know what they are, let's talk about what could be triggering it. So first, if you're really not doing anything differently with your skincare routine or your lifestyle, but they seem to have shown up just overnight and you think you've never had them before, well, you actually might be wrong about that. You might have had tiny, tiny, tiny little ones that you can't see, which are called, wait for it, microcomedones. Real creative. So if your skin looks clear, then boom, whiteheads and blackheads show up. It's possible you actually had some microcomedones, but they were just so small that you couldn't see them. What's important to know is if you are prone to getting whiteheads and blackheads, even if you think you don't have any at the moment, you should still be in prevention mode. But if you did just add a new product into your routine, that can definitely be a trigger, especially if it's an active ingredient that increases cell turnover, like exfoliating acids or retinoids. So if you've watched my niacinamide video, then you'll know all about purging and how to patch test when you're adding a new product into your routine. Something else that might tell you what the trigger is paying attention to where those CCs are showing up. Like, is it around your forehead, like if you have bangs like me, or your cheeks where your hair touches? Because if it is around here, then take a look at what hair products you're using, because sometimes they can transfer onto your skin. Oily pomades can be especially bad for your CCs, so maybe try cutting back on those if you can. This other trigger for CCs forming is a little bit more abstract: skin barrier dysfunction and water loss. Basically, your skin might actually be dehydrated and maybe even irritated from some of the products that you've been using. So you really want to avoid over-exfoliation. That means no harsh scrubs, because that could really disrupt your skin barrier even more. And also be sure to include a simple moisturizer with some ceramides thrown in there to give your skin barrier a little bit of TLC, especially if you've been using benzoyl peroxide, which we'll get into later on in the video. But you want to find a simple moisturizer that's not too emollient or too waxy feeling. CeraVe has a very simple moisturizing lotion. I'm talking about the PM one, and it's my go-to for when my skin is unhappy and I need to scale back to the basics. But I do know that in some countries it can be really expensive or it's always sold out. You don't need to use that one specifically, but you just want to find a nice, simple moisturizer. Okay, another trigger. We definitely have to talk about diet here. So, I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but two types of foods are linked to acne. The first is high glycemic foods, so sugary and high starch foods, basically everything that's delicious. And the second is drinking cow's milk. There's not enough data to link yogurt and cheese to acne, but you might want to put that glass of chocolate milk down and hide your candy and soda stash. Don't come for me, that's just what the research says. And the last potential trigger I wanted to talk about before we get into how to actually get rid of it is changing hormone levels. As they change throughout the month, that might trigger you to produce more oil, which makes it much more likely for your pores to get clogged up. So let's finally talk about some of the ingredients and products that I can recommend to help get rid of those CCs. Hint, hint, there is no anti-dandruff shampoo on that list. So the first step is to get in some gentle exfoliation to help you break up that clog. I know we just talked about why over-exfoliation isn't a good idea. So here I'm suggesting a low concentration of salicylic acid or glycolic acid. Yes, both AHAs and BHAs can help. AHAs basically soften the comedonal debris and lightly exfoliate, leaving it smoother and helping to open the comedones and let the debris out. But BHAs are fat soluble, so that means they can go deeper into the pore and actually break up the sebum and oil that's trapped deep down there. So they are a bit better for reducing the greasiness and also softening up the contents of the comedone. So since BHAs or salicylic acid can get deeper into the pore, I would recommend you start with that. And I really like salicylic acid in a cleanser because it's less irritating because it stays on your skin for a shorter amount of time. And I know that this is where some of you will say that actives and cleansers aren't effective because they're on for such a short amount of time before you wash it off. But there's actually studies that show that salicylic acid cleansers are effective at reducing acne. And I know some of you want receipts, so I will post those down below. So as for the cleansers, the salicylic acid cleansers I love are the Inculist salicylic acid cleanser and the CeraVe SA cleanser. And I know they sell out all the time. I had to literally go to 10 different drugstores to pick this up, but it's worth it. So if instead you wanted to go with a leave-on exfoliator, I'd recommend the Paula's Choice Skin Perfecting 2% BHA Liquid Exfoliant. I know there's a lot of hype around this and it is slightly more expensive. It's not a drugstore product. I was really skeptical about it. I don't know if you guys have tried it yet, but I think it's worth the hype. Another great addition to your routine, especially if you also have pimples, is a retinoid. What retinoids are useful for is actually preventing comedones. Once you have them, salicylic acid will break them down, but retinoids are there to help prevent them in the first place. So most of the ones that have been studied are available by prescription only, but if you're in the US, you can get adapalene pretty easily at the drugstore in a product called Differin. Differin is a great first-line retinoid topical treatment. If you can get your hands on Differin, make sure you apply it to your whole face because it's not meant to be a spot treatment. And if you're incorporating a retinoid, do it very, very slowly and definitely patch test. So that means apply it in a really small area where you want to test it at night. And don't forget to add on a sunscreen in the morning. A really common side effect with retinoids is an acne flare-up, which should go away over time. It's also known as a purge. Another ingredient that's really great is benzoyl peroxide. So benzoyl peroxide is an antibacterial agent, which is why if you have fungal acne, it won't help kill the fungus because fungus is different from bacteria. Benzoyl peroxide will kill that bacteria on your skin, but it will also dry out your skin. So if you're gonna incorporate benzoyl peroxide into your routine, don't forget the moisturizer. I also like it in a cleanser, so the CeraVe Foaming Acne Cleanser has 4% benzoyl peroxide in it, but also hyaluronic acid and niacinamide. It can be combined with salicylic acid, so especially if you've got pimples, that's a really great combination. Again, the downside to benzoyl peroxide is it can be extremely drying, so make sure you're using a moisturizer and that you're not overdoing it because it can cause your skin to overcompensate and actually produce more oil, especially if you have oily skin. And the last ingredient I want to talk about is azelaic acid. Azelaic acid helps by fighting the bacteria as well, so it prevents that bacteria from multiplying. It helps speed up cell turnover rates. It's also great for hyperpigmentation and it's pregnancy safe. The Ordinary has a great azelaic acid that's kind of like an interesting gel cream texture. It's also a very high concentration at 10%, so please patch test it before you incorporate it into your routine. Okay, so a lot of these products can make your skin much more sensitive to the sun. So, you know what I'm gonna say? always be sunscreening. And a lot of them also do increase cell turnover rates, so that might lead to a bit of purging as well. Oh, and I just really wanted to quickly talk about extracting. I know it's really, really fun and even satisfying to watch it happen, but please don't try to extract or squeeze them out at home, especially not with dirty hands and fingernails, because then you might end up with scarring. Try these topical treatments that I mentioned instead. I know topical treatments aren't going to be as satisfying as a really quick extraction because they can take a little bit longer, so 4 to 6 weeks before you see results, but please be patient, friends, because otherwise you will regret it later. I know, easier said than done. Okay, so that's it for me. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to give your girl a like and subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any more informative skincare videos like this one. See you next time.